Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Expedition Minecraft. The plan for today was to, let's go see, I'll show you, the cocoa bean and vine farm, to make sure I have those in my inventory, or hot bar, whatever you want to call them. Oh, there's already one there, okay. But as you can see, the vines were to go down this wall, and grow in there. And then along these walls here, from this point onwards, the vines were still meant to come down this bit. That wasn't the plan, but I noticed that when I got through to here, there's the wiring for my door here, so I can't actually build the piston pushy wall thing there, because there's already wiring behind it, so it has to be from here. There was the plan to be a sticky piston behind every one of these, so that the all the cocoa beans that were on the jungle wood that was there would be then pushed off. However, I've realised that I do not have enough slime balls or materials in general to get however many sticky pistons would be necessary. So the next plan, which would be a little bit uglier, but also more realistic, really, because I suppose I don't need that many cocoa beans ever, really, was to have, for example, pistons all up here, pushed out, and then on the other side, a whole bunch that were, or not all the way on the other side, but the max distance pistons can push, which is 12. So at that 12 distance, ones that are pushed in. And then on the T flip-flop, when the T flip-flop flips, shall I say, that one will extend and that one will shorten, or that set will extend, pushing all the logs one across that way, simultaneously popping off all the cocoa beans. But until we actually get cocoa beans, it's going to be hard to work out the logics for all that. And also, I still need a ton more sticky pistons and even redstone, because I'm running low on redstone at the moment, because I've overshot the amount of redstone that I'll need for all my projects. So that was meant to be the plan. That room still is going to be the vine and cocoa bean farm, but it just we'll have to continue and do other farms before that one's 100% finished. The plan for now though is to go get some vines quickly, so we can actually put the vines as the vine. So we there. So we can do the vine part of that room. Shoes. Let's go. Oh, damn it. Give me a second. I need to turn my Fraps volumes down. Once I get to the top, I'll pause it for a second so I can do that. Oh, breathe. Actually, what's the game sound on? If I just turn the game sound down a little bit, then because usually I have it on about 30, so if I put that on about 20, then overall it should be about the right amount anyway. If not, you can cope with one episode with slightly loud game sounds. Also, I fixed this after the creeper blew it up. Here are vines that need to be collected. Yeah, the plan for this episode, I haven't got much time to record as I doing stuff all day, but again, I set up a plan for the episode, and then just before starting recording, realised I couldn't actually go through with that plan, which is what I did a couple of episodes back as well, which got annoying. Or I set up a plan, and then something got in the way of that. Actually, even last episode, a little bit with the prank, that kind of got in the way of what the whole episode was going to be. Then again, the whole episode was going to be the vine and cocoa bean farm, so either way, I couldn't really have done it. Silk touch pick there. I have an idea for my next big prank. When I'm going to pull it off, I don't know. I'll have to get everything prepared again, like I did before for that one. It will take, it'll probably be like the end or mid to end of August or something, because the preparation for it is going to take quite a while to get all the resources that will be needed. Same as last time, I just had to. It just took me time to get all the cobble that I used up. Someone told me the other day that Xeno got rid of my giant cobble structure with World Edit. At which point, I nearly cried. Because if he actually did get rid of it with World Edit, that was 6 hours work for me to put it there and 3 seconds for him to get rid of it. If he even used Creative, that still kind of pissed me off. So if he has done either of those, I expect large amounts of compensation from him in the form of diamond blocks. Like a stack of them, maybe? No, but a lot. To be honest, maybe the other 7.5 stacks of glowstone I need to do these floors. That could be my compensation, Xeno, if you're watching this and you did in fact do that. It's time for me to sneeze, apparently. My nose is twitching and it's really annoying. It may not happen, actually. It's just gone away. It's coming back. It's going away again. There we are. It's gone. Okay. I didn't sneeze in the end. What was I saying? I forget. Oops. I don't know where that other one went. Yeah, I spread to there anyway. At some point, I'm going to put them there. I overshot it by quite a few, didn't I? But the person who told me that Xeno possibly got rid of my thing of World Edit or Creative said that it was because it was lagging the server. At which point, I clearly mentioned that the cobble in the sky could not have lagged the server in any way, because it's just extra blocks, and that doesn't affect that, because in that, for example, in the chunk that was loaded, yes, there was an extra 16 by 16 of cobble in the sky. So, yes, I agree, that's fair enough. But within that chunk, there's a whole underground bit which consists of many hundreds of times more blocks than the cobble in the sky. So it couldn't have been the amount of cobble. Also, they said it could have been the flowing water. However, Flammable Penguin had already got rid of all the flowing water, and it was just stationary water, which doesn't cause any lag. Like this type of water, which is just sitting there. Which doesn't cause any lag, or very, very small amounts. About as much as having a block placed there. So either way, it couldn't have been that. So I don't see how at all it was lagging the server. So if Xeno got rid of it for that reason, that's definitely compensation worthy. And if he got rid of it because he just didn't like the way it looked next to spawn, that's compensation worthy, because eventually it would have been gone anyway. So if it is true, I'm rather annoyed with you, Xeno, if you're watching this. If it is not true, then by all means, I apologise. But it seemed to be clear. The whole thing seemed to be cleared up very quickly, which suggests that somebody probably did cheat to get it gone in the first place. I still need 3 more glowstone to finish off these corner bits in this one and one bit over there. But yeah, I would accept 8 stacks of glowstone as compensation. So enough for this, and then a little on the side. Maybe 10 stacks would do, to be honest. But I think that's the plan for today, to be honest, is... I've said to be honest a fair few times now. Is to go to the Nether and get glowstone, because I'm eventually going to need it at some point, and even if I overstock with it, at least then I will have spare to build with my heart's content. On my private server / world thing that I play on with my close friends, we've set up a potions room. Well, I've set up a potions room, pretty much within it, and I've got the same. I've basically used it as a test for the circuitry system that I wanted to use in this world. So I already have how to do that set up. It's just a matter of getting enough items and stuff to actually implement it into this server, the expedition video server. Right, time for some nether adventuring. I will switch those over actually. So we don't ever really need a spade on us in the nether, apart from for soul sand, in which case I just use my pick anyway. Oh, by the way, another part of the prank for last episode was just that Fat Cat put his name here. He kind of put it in the way that, I suppose from this side it does say Fat Cat, but it says Cat Fat from this side, so I don't know. Doesn't really matter though, does it? Either way. Yeah, I love my silk touch pick for glowstone harvesting. I'm thinking of putting signs all down this side of it so that vines can't grow on it, because I like to use it as like going into it to drop really far down and then come back into this side at the last second, as so it goes down quickly, but vines keep growing into that side, so I can't actually do that at the moment. Is out. Okay. Haven't seen that yet, really. The nether seems to be getting a bit of an overhaul, which is good. I want to have that one spawn portal. I want that whole thing to be turned into a nether hub, like in the Minecraft server, because we need somewhere to just have portals to everyone's places and just to know where people's houses and things are. So this is I just took a screenshot. So this is about, let me see, that way goes to the, so that's about 100, so it's about 50, it's about 50x100z, I should remember it. Oh, lag attack. There we are. Recording and being in the nether is probably the worst things to do in Minecraft. It's never a good idea, usually. Never usually. This looks like a prime pocket for stealing or removing from its home. It's not stealing. Wow, I like my minimap thing, especially in the nether where it doesn't show anything at all. Whoa, lava pool. To be honest, I can swim in lava, no problems. My armour is just that good. Put out these fires. This is a prime pocket as well. Let's get this one first though, because it's very much so not above much lava. I love glowstone, I just don't have enough. Oh, I'm jumping. I'm trying to itch my head, so I can't click anymore. Keep clicking. I just don't ever get enough glowstone to actually make stuff properly. Oh, I broke some netherrack there as well. We've already got 11 glowstone in that pile of it there. And there's a whole bunch more down here. That looked like more than that. Let's build a bridge of sorts. That bubbling lava sound does get a tad annoying in the nether, and the lag does too. Oh, hello. I know that ghast's gonna shoot me in a second, by the way. Or something. Oh, he's gone. That's a relief, at least. Oh, no! Oh, that was close. We may have to extend it one more this way to secure all that glowstone that's still on the edge there. I wanted to burst out into song there, but I didn't. I had a song that rhymed quite well with glowstone. Oh, two bits burned, damn it. Oh, well. That's a nice small amount. It's enough to. Oh! Lag attack! I don't like the nether. They should make it better. That's what they should base 1.4 around, is just making the nether actually a place that someone wants to be in. Because no one wants to be in the nether, ever. The lava's nice, of course, but. It's a bit crap, isn't it? I mean, I don't see. There's a pride thing involved with. Shit. Tried to knock you off your block! Oh, you bastard. God damn it. I have to swim really slowly out of this. Still burning, damn it. And the lag isn't helping either. Oh, another prime pocket of glowstone. Oh, no, they're not angry. The lag and the pigmen together frightened me. Whoa. I almost overshot that. Just a small amount. Way overshot it. There's two there that could be. I could secure those two glowstone, but I don't particularly need to. I always make these things. I don't want to make them too big, so I haven't actually got that much cobble. This side too. Oh, no, not that sort of two. Right. Ooh, come on. Well, I seem to build that platform pretty damn well sized, because none of it fell off yet. Nope. Perfect. So we have above 64 and 22. There we are. I'm so good at Minecraft with my amazingness at Minecraft. I'm sorry, I don't like making sense. It's just one of my things. How the bloody hell did I do that? Okay. Ah, a very secure pocket of glowstone with no lava beneath it, so I can just dig it straight out, not have to worry. Ghast as well. Ghasts are annoying when you're trying to collect glowstone. Whoa, there's a lot of it. As I was saying a minute ago, the pride factor involved with Minecraft. Oh no, don't block my glowstone! I'm gonna get it first. You bastards. They won't implement any mods into the actual game, really. Not without. changing it or changing it that way. I mean, oh, shut up, more noisy. Oh, other ghast hit me. Oh, I hit his ghast ball away from him. I'm not going to ever hit him from like this, am I? Oh, flippin' heck, he didn't die from a power 5 bow. I definitely hit him, he squealed like a little bubby. Like the amount of times that I've thought and... I mean, just put the Aether in the game, for Christ's sake. You don't even have to have it as good as it is in the mod. Take everything else out of it. Just have it so there's islands and trees and things. That would be everyone's favourite update to the game ever. You wouldn't even have to have the bosses and people would be happy. That would be amazing. But literally just having a portal out of glowstone that you put a bucket of water in to go to, like, the heaven land. Just have it spawn the same and have those types of blocks. You can build with more different types of blocks. That would be the coolest thing ever to be in the game. Because, like, the end is bloody hard to get to, and the nether is a pile of crap. And so you're basically stuck with being able to do things just in the normal world, because the rest of it is rubbish. So if they just put the Aether in the game... I mean, of course, it'd be so good if they had all the bosses and stuff as, like, real endgame things. Or have the Aether, but you have to have killed the end dragon, and then use the dragon egg to light the portal or something. I don't bloody know. Or use the dragon egg with the portal and it will light it, but then you obviously it doesn't get rid of the dragon egg, so you can do it multiple times, but then again you could still have something that's even, it's like wherever, when there's endgame stuff, it's like the extra stuff after the endgame stuff in like an MMO. It's like obviously there's the endgame stuff, and then afterwards you wouldn't play it again otherwise. So they always put like extra missions and quests in that you can do. I mean, if they had the Aether as that sort of thing, and had if they just had the Aether, it'd be so cool. Just like make it so that you have to have killed the end dragon, so it's a really hard place to get to, and then because I like having things that are hard to do in Minecraft, because it's too easy. It is way too easy at the moment for any player. It is just the easiest thing in the world, pretty much, because I mean, there's nothing hard to gather anymore. They're making coca beans easy to get. To be honest, okay, endstone and the stronghold bricks are not infinite, but they're not hard to get either. You can get them quite easily, but then you just have to be careful with what you do with them. So they're the only things that are rare in the game anymore, really. I mean, there's an infinite amount of nether fortresses. So you can always get nether bricks very easily. What else? I mean, just having the Aether in there would just be so much cooler, because it's... Having it the way that I'm saying... I mean, other people have probably suggested this before, but... It would secure the fact that Minecraft can expand. It would just be amazing in general, and everyone would adore it. You'd have to have like a couple of the mobs. You wouldn't have to have all of them. Bloody thing, where are you? I can't even see you. How are you shooting at me? Well, I can't see you. You're looking for lava to shoot me, I know that. Oh, that was a terrible shot. See what he dropped, actually, because ghast tears are extremely hard to come by. Oh, he didn't drop any. Just gunpowder. Whoa, lag! I hate you. But yeah, Aether would be cool. And then everyone would stop complaining as well, so... It's like, the stuff they're putting in the game is just people, it's just the whingy people's things, isn't it? It's like, I can't find cocoa beans. Okay, we'll make cocoa bean plant. Done. I want to be able to write in books for adventure maps. And it's not making the actual game any better. It's making the added things that you can put on the game better. I mean, of course, it's making the community better and things like that. But I just want to be able to play on a server like this and make YouTube videos. And the more things that are in the actual game that people give a shit about, the better. I couldn't care less about cocoa beans. Of course, it's now giving me a new farm to have to make by having these cocoa beans in the game. I have to now make a cocoa bean farm. So it's allowing me to make more videos, but just of crap that I don't care about. Just want something better in the game. Like, I remember when they released the Nether. It was still the same old pile of crap, but it was so cool because it wasn't just the normal world that you've been stuck with in Alpha for however many months it was, or however long it was. It was something brand new that everybody adored because, yes, it was a pile of crap. It was this stone and soul sand and some lava and some glowstone and some fires and two new mobs. I mean, yeah, it was a massive update at the time as well. So if they just either updated the Nether so it's better, or just added, I mean they've done that slightly by putting the fortresses in, but that's all they've done, pretty much. But if they just added the Aether or whatever they want to call it, like heaven or whatever, I don't care. If they just added that, even if it was just as crap as the Nether was when it first started, it would be adored for like a year. Because it would be that new world. And like the end, of course, yeah, the end's the new world. But it's rubbish. There's the end dragon fight, and then you can make Enderman XP farms. And that's basically it in the end. That's the end, as a whole. That's it done. That's the end explained. Is boss fight, and then lots of XP from then on. We have a lot of glowstone now. I am impressed with myself. We need more netherrack. That's the netherrack dump that I need. Let's climb up. Oh, I placed two in different places. God damn it. I'll need to get some more slime balls for the sticky pistons that I'm going to use. I need a slime farm, but I need to find slime chunks that I can use. With my minimap mod, I can find slime chunks that I could use. I'm very glad about that. It's kind of cheating. To be honest, that's what I did with my expedition. My original expedition single player world was just looked at what slime chunks there were in the files and stuff. And that's how I found my area that I dug out, which had three slime chunks in the four chunk. In the 2x2 chunk area, so 3 out of the 4 were slime chunks, which is why I made that farm there. But I need to make another slime farm in the real world, in the normal world, on the server in normal world. There we are. It'll have to be really far away from the it'll have to be just like, I might make it in spawn as like the community one, because at the moment it's oh sugar. I can't have it at my base because then the room itself would have to be enormous, and that would interrupt with the size of other rooms and what they need to be. So if I just have one at spawn which is deep underground, obviously the right level and stuff like that, then that can be just the one that everyone goes to if they want slime balls. And I'm pretty happy to make things at spawn by myself if it's for my use as well as others, because then it's just it's basically what I want to make plus helping out others, which I'm fine with. Really, I'm going to be annoyed in 1.3 if they keep all the weird bloody bugs about placing blocks underneath you, because at the moment where you can click like this and just infinitely go up like this, right, in 1.3 you can do it twice and then it bugs out and you have to like stop like this for like 5 seconds and then keep going. Otherwise it just breaks. So I'm praying that that's gone, because that's the thing that everyone does in the game. There's nobody who hasn't done that, pretty much. Well, no, I'm pretty sure there's nobody who hasn't done that unless they just like started the game yesterday. Hello, fat cat. That's that glowstone done. Oh, I didn't check for fires underneath here that glowstone could have fallen in. I think I'm alright though. I don't mind losing one or two bit. Whoa! Glitchy, glitch, glitch. Stop it! Oh no. Please fix it. Please fix yourself. Please fix yourself. No! Hey guys, I'm playing Jumpy today. Ugh. I don't want to disconnect because then I have to edit the video to get to the IP thing. Well, I saved it. To be honest, it doesn't matter if you guys know the IP anyway because it's whitelisted. So I could just do that. But, meh. I've always felt safer in case, like, I don't know how someone could hack it, but I'm sure someone can actually hack it. I don't know, I'm just jabbering about crap. I feel like I need to edit it out, otherwise I'm giving away secrets. Secrets that don't exist. Four stacks, nearly. Get this one more and then I'll head back. And place those three more glowstone that I need in that one corner, and then, probably off camera do another one in the corners, because you've seen me do one, so you don't need to see me do another three. Oh, lag, Christ. I don't know where Xeno is, I haven't seen him in weeks now. It's been a while at least. I'm just gonna have to build a platform up there, because I can't remove all that lava so that the thing doesn't fall in it, or the glowstone doesn't fall in it. I'm just gonna have to build a platform about here. If a ghast shoots this, I'm screwed. Should be alright. That was close. Oh, you bloody. I went to the zoo today. I'm 5 years old. No. People could enjoy the zoo if they're older. I had to go because I was helping out the school who was going on a trip. So, meh. Fair enough. So, that was fun. It was basically just, let's see the rules for 20 minutes, now let's play on the play area. That was it. Pretty much. Don't shoot me again! Leave my platform alone! Quickly build it. Oh dear. He missed. You bastard. As long as he's under me, he's always gonna shoot over the top of me and miss. Oh, pick it up. There we are. I have over 4 stacks now. Very, very soon. I'm getting annoyed by this oddly shaped one I have at the moment. So that should be very, very good. It's quite small as well on my desk. I want something that's... I'm gesturing with my hands how big I want it to be. I was going to say the words that big and how stupid I would have seemed there. Probably 27 inch, maybe a little bit bigger. Because having done my exams recently, my granddad has promised me 30 Great British Pounds sterling for each one I pass. And to be honest, passing an exam is a C grade, so I shouldn't really have a problem passing them all. So I'm basically counting that as I have £330 already, because we have 11 subjects. Oh no, not every exam I pass, every subject that I pass. So like I get, but here, my mum said try and get as much money as you can out of him. So I'm counting English literature and English language as two different subjects. So, so that's, and then if I get an A star in any of them, he said, or any that I get A stars in, he said that's £50. At which point I said to him, £50 extra or just £50? And he laughed and said just the £50, which is fair enough. But I think sciences, I'm pretty sure that I'll get A-stars, I want to say. Well, seeing as in the sciences, I already have an A-star so far, and then the exams that we did recently are just an extra 25%, so as long as I didn't completely fuck them up, I've got an A-star. So that's another 60 added onto the 330 that I'm going to get. And then anything else that I get A-stars in, which I'm hoping a few more subjects, then it's extra money as well. So obviously that, I'm not going to want to spend all that on a monitor, so I'm going to spend about maximum 260 on a monitor, and then leave some out, or have some left for like games, back in my bank and things. Also, my parents are going to pay me for what exam results I get, so that's some more. My dad was like, one, a nickel each. We don't even count in nickels, but he said a nickel. He's been watching too much American television. Too much American television is what my sentence was supposed to be. My mum was like, no. She said, originally she was like, 50 for a pass, and I was like, And then she changed it. I was like, okay. And then she was like, I meant 50 for any grade you get above your target grade. And my target grade for all the subjects is an A. So getting above my target grade is an A star. So basically, for an A star, I get 50 and I get nothing else. So I said to her, what about on target? And she was just like, okay, on target as well. I was like, thank you. So hopefully, it's quite likely that I'll get the majority A's. I'm not meaning to boast here. It's more likely that I'll get more A's than I will, like, or A's and A stars than I will B's. Hoping at least. I mean, I revised a lot, and I spent a lot of time working on that, which is why I didn't record any videos for 4 weeks, whenever that was, the end of May, or whenever that was. I did, like, the odd one-off video, like, once a week, maybe, if that. So I hope that that was worth, that time that I had away from YouTube was worth the money I'll get to pay for this PC that I've got recently and pay for a new monitor so I can enjoy the game more while I'm playing it and recording it for you guys. I said I'd stop collecting glowstone ages ago, didn't I? But this is too fun. And I, look at it, look how much I have, dude. 6.5, over 6.5. So this is nearly enough to actually finish all three corners of that room that I need to finish. So see how fun this is? It breaks with such a gratifying noise. Oh crap! And also it's my birthday very soon. My 16th. Which is obviously one of the big ones. End of July. Anyone wants to send me a birthday present or anything? Just, I'm sure I can, if you ask, I can set up, you can pay my PayPal, however much you want to pay me. Just, end of July. Well, very end of July. First, so, last possible day. It's my 16th. And, hopefully I'll get, I've asked for money for that, for my 16th to pay for the PC. So I'm not expecting a grand overall a grand from everybody so that I'll have paid the whole thing off. I'm expecting like 250 to 400, so that pays off some of it. So I could pay off like the whole thing if I, all the money I get for exams plus all my birthday money, I could probably pay off the whole PC, but I want a monitor as well and some money left over for games. So my exam money I'm going to keep for games and monitor, and then birthday money I'll probably put away as paying back towards the PC. 8, 7 and 12. 7 stacks and 12. Lighting glitch. Problem solved. I never know how long I record for. I can't believe that my first however many videos, I actually had a timer and stuck it to 15 minutes, because I can't keep time in these videos. This, in my head, I just thought to myself, what's this, about 30 minutes now? And then I thought, to be honest, it's probably not. It's probably, like, an hour. And then I thought to myself, well, the other day I thought my DC video was an hour and a half, so I rushed to end it. And then it turned out to be just under an hour. So I was just like, I have no concept of time when I record. At all. I honestly don't have a clue what I'm on about when I record. Well, time-wise. I also don't have a clue what I'm on about when I record just in general, but... Oops, I fell off. Oh, damn it. Okay, that's put us up to almost 8 stacks. I feel so powerful. Just because I have glowstone. They're high up, can't be bothered to get them. That one is above a ridge. I might get that one and then I will go. I promise. I will not hang around any longer. Because this could be anything between 30 minutes and an hour and a half, this video. Because I don't have a clue when I started. Well, I got home at 5 today. 5 in the afternoon. And then I was downstairs sorting stuff out until about 5:30-ish, that is. So this is probably about 40 minutes long. And I'm probably completely wrong, so don't blame me when I get it wrong. I'm guessing at 40 minutes-ish, but I probably got home at 4 and didn't realize, and thought it was 5, so this is probably an hour and 45 minutes. I'm guessing about 45 minutes. That's just a guess. Please don't shout at me if I'm wrong. Oh dear. Oh, there's another piece there. I'm getting to the stage where I'm like, I don't care if I lose pieces of it. But then again, that all adds up, doesn't it? I don't need that. Oh, 8.5 stacks. Oh, just over 8.5 stacks. I am the god of Minecraft. Okay, let's run back. We'll place those last 3. Oh god, I don't know where run back is. Because I don't know where I have to get back to. Oh dear. Misa lost, sir. Oh dear. I swear I'm going the wrong way in the X direction. And the Z direction. It was both this way. It's about this way. I don't know. I'm lost. I don't want to die. Okay. I won't actually get back in this episode. I'll probably end the episode here. And then, chat to one of the guys online and say, can you please go to the nether portal and find its coordinates, because I'm lost. But yeah, I don't want to be wandering around for ages on camera looking for it just to place 3 blocks of glowstone. So by next episode, I will have those 3 blocks placed. So one corner will be 100% complete. And then hopefully I will either have done one other of the corners or just finish them all off. So, basically, by next episode, there'll be more glowstone in my floor in my base. So, we'll get up here. We'll go the scenic route. The non-scenic route, even. Look how close these glowstone pockets are. But then again, they are, like, really high up, so I can't be bothered. I'll end the episode here, guys. Thanks for watching and listening to my rant about the Aether and money about and monitors and stuff. Should we make a spectacular ending? Don't kill me! They didn't kill me. I'm so powerful. They did like no hearts. They're so weak. End up being weak, baby. Little bummy. I'm weak, you can't kill me. I am strong, you are a dickhead. Couldn't rhyme fast enough, I am definitely not a poet. That's more gold and a helmet. Put it on. Don't want to. It's weak. And we'll throw that away. Keep that and keep that for now. Stop. Lag attack. I hate the nether. I hate the nether. Gosh, the lag. Stop it. I think, Zeno, I think it's all this flowing lava. You better, like, delete the nether so that there's no lag. I'm just teasing. Thanks for watching this episode, guys. I will see you next time.